Today is Thursday, August 27th, and our epistle reading for this coming Sunday is taken from Romans 12 at verse 9. Let love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in suffering. Persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the saints. Extend hospitality to strangers. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not claim to be wiser than you are. Do not repay anyone evil for evil, but take thought for what is noble in the sight of all. If it is possible, so far as it depends on you, live peaceably with all. Beloved, never avenge yourselves, but leave room for the wrath of God. For it is written, "Vengeance is mine, I will repay," says the Lord. No, if your enemies are hungry, feed them. If they are thirsty, give them something to drink. For by doing so, you will be heaping coals on their heads. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. On this coming 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time, the 13th after Pentecost, let us pray. Almighty God, you alone can order unruly wills and affections. Help us to love what you command and desire what you promise, that in the midst of this changing world, our hearts may be fixed where true joys are found. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever, and whose Son Jesus has taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. We invite you to worship with us at 10 o'clock or any time thereafter this coming Sunday, August 30th. And we remind you that following worship, we have our Zoom time that we can check in with each other and offer prayers for each other. So we bid you farewell in this good day, and we trust that God will go with us. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit rest and remain with each one this day, this night, and forevermore. Amen.